Here is a little update. Somehow, I recorded the last two lectures, but somehow the audio didn't come in those lectures. So it totally, matlab, video dikh raha hai, audio kuch nahi aa raha hai usme se. So what we will do, I am going to just revise whatever we did in a previous lecture, and then I am going to derive the complete canonical ensemble derivation. So that it, whatever we have covered, that will be included in this lecture. So in 15-20 minutes I will be revising the last few lectures and then we will continue. So in last few lectures we discuss about the interaction of two systems. So if I have two systems, let's say system A and A prime, and if they are interacting by exchanging energy, then what's going to happen, that we discuss. And we said that okay, if this is the case, we are going to consider a total system. And the energy of total system will be equal to E0 is the energy of total system, and that will be equal to E, which is energy of system A, plus E prime, which is energy of system A prime, if these two systems are weakly interacting. So we have considered a weak interaction. Then we discuss about what is weak interaction. Weak interaction means the exchange of energy is much less than the energy of a system. So the exchange is very very slow. That's what we said is weak interaction is. Then what we want in this particular case, so our system of interest is system A. So this is our system, and A prime is the system which with it is interacting. So it could be another system or it could be a thermal reservoir. So what we want, we want that, what is the probability that a system A is in a state with energy E. So that would be given by probability that a system A has energy E when total energy of a combined system is E0, right? And that would be given by number of accessible states when A has energy E and total energy E is 0, divided by total number of accessible states when the total energy is E0. And these accessible states are is of combined system. So we have seen this particular thing and we derived this particular equation. We have a recorded video for this. So we come at this particular relation. Omega 0 E0 is equal to omega E into omega E prime. What is this omega 0 E? Okay, so these are combined system, accessible states of combined system. And what is this omega E? It is the states of system A only. Obviously, when it has energy E, this is also when A has energy E. And what is this omega prime E prime? Accessible states of system A prime. And when A has energy E. A prime ka energy E prime honga, magar A ka energy kitna honga? E. That time only this is going to happen na, because you have written E0 is equal to E plus E prime. So agar A prime ka energy E prime hai, to A ka energy kitna hona chahiye? E hona chahiye. Right? So if you look carefully over here, I can write this E prime as E0 minus E. E0 is equal to E plus E prime. So I can write E prime is equal to E0 minus E. And if I do that, I am going to get an equation something like this. Omega 0 E will be equal to omega E into omega prime E 0 minus E. Now, as energy goes on increasing, as E goes on increasing, what is going to happen to E 0 minus E? E 0 is constant number. So, what will happen if E increases to E 0 minus E? Increase honga or decrease honga? It's very easy. Suppose ki aapke class mein do log hai. Do logo ke paas total money 100 rupees hai. उस 100 रुपीज में से एक के पास अगर पैसा बढ़ता गया तो दूसरे के पास पैसा कम होते जाना चाहिए. सपोज इनिशियली दोनों के पास 50-50 रुपीज थे, तो पर्सन ए ने क्या किया, पर्सन बी से 10 रुपए लिए, उसके पास 60 रुपीज हो गए. पर्सन ए के पास कितने होंगे फिर, 40 रुपीज हो जाएंगे. उसने और 20 रुपीज लिए तो पर्सन बी के पास 20 रुपीज हो जाएंगे, पर्सन ए के पास 80 रुपीज हो जाएंगे. टोटल रुपीज 100 ही रहने वाले हैं. सो दैट्स व्हाट इज हैपनिंग ओवर हियर. सो इफ ए इज इंक्रीजिंग, E0 minus E is decreasing, that is E prime is decreasing. And as we know that this omega E is function of energy. So it depends on energy. So if energy increases, omega E also increases, and it increases rapidly, very rapidly increasing function of energy. It is a very rapidly increasing function of energy. So if I try to draw a graph of this omega 0 E, it will be something like this. This is on y axis I have written omega 0 E, on x axis I have E, and this red color represent omega E, and the blue green color will represent omega prime E prime. So as energy increases, omega E will increase, and what's going to happen when E increases to omega prime E 0 minus E? E 0 minus E is decreasing, so this also will decrease rapidly. So yahan pe dikhaya hua hai green color mein, so it is decreasing very rapidly, and as a result the combined function will be the multiplication of both these functions. So the multiplication will look something like this. So omega 0 E will have a maximum at one particular energy, and that energy is known as E tilde. Now why I am concerned about this omega 0 E? Because my probability of finding the system in energy E is given by this number, omega 0 E divided by omega 0 E 0. So the probability depends on omega 0 E. So if omega 0 E has some maxima at one particular point, my probability will also have the maxima at that particular point only. So what I'm trying to say over here is that if I allow the system to exchange energy and I don't know what is the energy of a system A, then the system will start interacting with each other, and a situation will arise when at one particular energy of system A there is an equilibrium, and that energy I am designating over here by this E tilde. So this is that particular energy, and our aim now is to find out this equilibrium energy E tilde. By the way, humne jab dekha tha equilibrium, that time what we said, at equilibrium the probability of accessible state, the number of accessible state is maximum, correct? Yaad aa raha hai, humne example liya tha uske liye. So yahan pe dekho, the number of accessible state is maximum, that's why I am calling it as a equilibrium state. The number of accessible state are maximum, that's why I am calling it as the equilibrium state. So now my job is simply reduced to finding out what is this equilibrium energy, and as I know that at this particular energy this omega 0 E is a maximum, this is a maxima, I can use the properties of maxima. What are the properties of maxima? First derivative is 0 and the second derivative is negative. Okay, so we are going to use the first derivative condition. So if f of x is a maxima or minima, then the first derivative, partial derivative with respect to x, since it is a function of x, the first derivative with respect to x will be equal to 0. Now over here this probability P is a function of energy. You can see over here P of E is a function of energy. This omega is function of energy, so P of P will be a function of energy. So I need to differentiate it with respect to energy. So the first derivative of probability with respect to energy will be equal to 0. And if this is true, then even if I take natural logarithm of energy, probability, then it will also be equal to 0. And since the probability of finding system A in energy E is given by this particular equation, omega 0 E divided by omega 0 E 0. What is omega 0 E 0? Exactly, it's the all the possible accessible states of the combined system when the energy is E 0, right? So P of E will be equal to omega 0 E divided by omega 0 E 0, and I can write it to be equal to proportional to omega E into omega prime E 0 minus E. Why? Because I can write omega 0 E as omega E into ओमेगा प्राइम ई जीरो माइनस ई, एंड वाई प्रोपोर्शनल, बिकॉज दिस ओमेगा जीरो ई जीरो विल बी अ कॉन्स्टेंट नंबर, बिकॉज ई जीरो इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट नंबर, सो प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट अ सिस्टम ए विल हैव एनर्जी ई इज इक्वल टू सी इंटू ओमेगा ई इंटू ओमेगा प्राइम ई जीरो माइनस ई. सो वेन आई टेक अ नेचुरल लॉगरिथम ऑफ दिस प्रोबेबिलिटी आई एम गोइंग टू गेट ln of c plus ln of omega e plus ln of omega prime e 0 minus e. And when I differentiate it with respect to e, so dab by ln p by dab by e, this has to be equal to 0 because this is the maximum probability. And when this will be equal to 0? When energy is equal to e tilde. Look over here. The probability is maximum at e tilde. So when I differentiate it, at energy is equal to E tilde, I'm going to get it is this is equal to 0. So dabba by dabba E ln of C plus dabba by dabba E ln of omega E plus dabba by dabba E ln of omega prime E 0 minus E. And what that would be equal to? So ln of C, C is a constant. So differentiation of constant is equal to 0. Then dabba by dabba E ln of omega E. So that would be dabba by dabba E ln of omega E. Let me write it at energy E tilde plus differentiation of this will be dab by ln of omega E 0 minus E. I can write as omega E prime. So E prime into dab by E prime into dab by E prime by E. So what is this? Dab by E prime by dab by E. So E prime is equal to E 0 minus E. So dab by E prime by dabba E will be equal to 0 minus 1. If I differentiate this, so this will be equal to minus 1. So over here I have written minus 1. And hence this will be equal to, this equation will be same, dabba ln of E, dabba by dabba E ln of omega E. This is at energy E tilde. Dabba dabba E prime ln of omega prime E prime. This is also at E tilde into minus 1. So that would be dab by ln of omega e minus dab by e prime ln of omega prime e prime, and this is equal to 0. So if I rearrange this equation, I'm going to get the derivative of ln of omega e is equal to the derivative of ln of omega prime e. So when this particular thing gets satisfied, I will get a equilibrium, because ये जो होगा दिस विल बी इक्वल टू जीरो व्हेन ओमेगा जीरो ई इज मैक्सिमम, एंड दिस विल बी इक्वल टू मैक्सिमम व्हेन इक्विलिब्रियम टेक प्लेस. व्हेन ओमेगा जीरो इज मैक्सिमम देयर इज अ इक्विलिब्रियम. सो दिस इज अनदर कंडीशन ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम. सो द कंडीशन फॉर इक्विलिब्रियम इज डेबा एलन ऑफ ओमेगा ई बाय डेबा ई इज इक्वल टू dabba ln of omega prime e dabba e. Now omega e, what is the dimension of omega e? Is a number. Number ka koi dimension hota hai kya? Physical dimension? No. So it's a dimensionless quantity. This is dimensionless quantity. Then what will be the dimension of omega e, ln of omega e? Again dimensionless. I have just processed it using some mathematics. Dimensionless. Now if this is dimensionless, then what will be the dimension of dabba ln of omega e dabba e? What will be the dimension of this? This is divided by energy. So the dimension of dabba ln of omega e by dabba e is, this will be 1 over e. So the dimension will be minus joule. The dimension of dabba ln of omega e by dabba e is 1 over e. And in order to make it dimensionless quantity, I'm going to introduce a parameter t such that dabba ln of omega e by dabba e is equal to 1 over kt. I'm going to define this particular term. And hence, I'm going to define this 1 over kt as beta. So I have defined a quantity beta which is equal to 1 over kt, where K is the Boltzmann constant and T is absolute temperature. Absolute temperature means temperature in degree Kelvin. So if I write beta is equal to, so that would be equal to beta dab by ln of omega e by dab by e, what I'm going to get? The equilibrium condition, what the equilibrium condition become? Beta is equal to beta prime. And this implies that 1 over kt is equal to 1 over kt prime. And this implies that at equilibrium, t is equal to t prime. So if I have two systems, this is system A, this is system A prime. And if they are interacting with each other, if they are exchanging energy, the energy of this is E prime. And after some time, there will be equilibrium. At equilibrium, what will be constant for both systems? Temperature. So, agar iska temperature T rahega, to iska bhi temperature T rahega. So, when two systems are exchanging energy, when will you say that the systems are in equilibrium with each other? When both systems have same temperature, equilibrium takes place. Equilibrium is established. और अगर टेम्परेचर सेम नहीं है तो डिफरेंस है टेम्परेचर में तो दोनों सिस्टम के अभी तक टेम्परेचर मतलब अभी तक इक्विलिब्रियम फॉर्म नहीं हुआ है. सो अपना हमेशा का एग्जांपल, फ्रिज में से मैंने बोतल निकाली, टेबल पे रख दी, रूम का टेम्परेचर 30 डिग्री था, बोतल का टेम्परेचर 10 डिग्री है, इक्विलिब्रियम है क्या? रूम का टेम्परेचर 30, बोतल का टेम्परेचर 10 डिग्री, इक्विलिब्रियम फॉर्म हुआ है क्या? इक्विलिब्रियम नहीं है. फिर क्या होगा? जो बॉटल है वो रूम में से हीट एब्जॉर्ब करेंगी हीट रूम से, राइट? उसके बाद में थोड़ी देर के बाद क्या होगा? रूम का टेम्परेचर तो चेंज होने वाला नहीं है, राइट? बॉटल की वजह से, बिकॉज इट्स अ हीट सिंक, राइट? आफ्टर सम टाइम व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन? द टेम्परेचर ऑफ रूम इज 30 डिग्री एंड द टेम्परेचर ऑफ बॉटल इज 25 डिग्री. इज इट इन इक्विलिब्रियम? लेट्स से कि after 2-3 hours, what's happened? The temperature, room temperature is 30 degrees Celsius and the bottle temperature is also 30 degrees Celsius. Now what? Now it is in equilibrium. Does it mean that they are not exchanging energy with each other now? Aisa hai kya? The bottle is not absorbing energy and it is not giving away energy. Aisa kuch hai kya? No. Aisa, wahan pe phir bhi exchange ho raha hai. Abhi exchange kaise ho raha hai? Agar bottle ne suppose बॉटल में से एक वाटर मॉलिक्यूल ने अगर 10 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट ऑफ एनर्जी अब्सॉर्ब किया, लेट्स से फर्स्ट मॉलिक्यूल ने 10 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट ऑफ एनर्जी अब्सॉर्ब किया, तो सेकंड मॉलिक्यूल क्या करेगा? 10 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट एनर्जी एनवायरनमेंट को गिव अप करेगा. सो द टोटल चेंज इन एनर्जी इज इक्वल टू जीरो फॉर द बॉटल एंड ऑल्सो फॉर द एनवायरनमेंट. मगर वहां पे एक्सचेंज तो हो रहा है ना, फर्स्ट ने भी एक्सचेंज किया हुआ है एनर्जी और सेकंड पार्टिकल ने भी एक्सचेंज किया. So even though equilibrium takes place, there will be a change of energy, but the total energy of system will not change. Because jitna energy wo le rahi hai, utna energy wo wapas dengi. So this is what is very important. Abhi ye kaun sa ensemble tha? What kind of ensemble we have considered over here? What is it exchanging? It's only exchanging energy. So it's a canonical ensemble. So that's what we said. In canonical ensemble, we say that equilibrium takes place when temperature of both the systems are equal. Look over here. When we discuss about canonical ensemble, where is it? Yahan pe. See, yahan pe maine bola tha, at equilibrium, temperature T system A will be equal to temperature of system A prime. This is for canonical ensemble. This is canonical ensemble. Canonical ensemble, temperature of system A is equal to temperature of system A prime. And that's have been proved over here. So, when two systems are canonical system and they are interacting, then at equilibrium, both will have same temperature. So, the energy of system corresponding to that temperature is your equilibrium energy. So, us temperature ke liye jo kuch aapka energy honga, that will be your equilibrium energy. Is temperature and energy related? What is thermal energy? Thermal energy is equal to KT. For free gases, you write the energy of gases is equal to 3 by 2 kT. This is the thermal energy per degrees of freedom. Sorry, half kT. Yahan pe half chahiye. Half kT. So, us temperature ke corresponding jo kuch aapka energy honga, that will be your equilibrium energy. So, hamara jo job tha ki ye energy kitna hai, wo find out karne ka, it reduced to finding out what is the temperature. इक्विलिब्रियम टेम्परेचर एंड द एनर्जी कोरस्पॉन्डिंग टू डिस इक्विलिब्रियम टेम्परेचर ई टिल्डा इज माय इक्विलिब्रियम एनर्जी. नाउ देयर इज अनदर कंसेप्ट नोन एज एंट्रोपी ऑफ अ सिस्टम एंड एंट्रोपी ऑफ अ सिस्टम इज ऑल्सो defined as S is equal to K ln of omega. This is the definition of statistical definition of entropy. So let me write that over here again. So the first thing that we got from this is T is equal to T prime at equilibrium. Then we defined S is equal to K ln of omega E. This is the entropy. Now suppose I have a system A and it evolved into some system A prime. So this is initial and this is final. Now what will happen? Suppose the energy over here is E, over here is E prime. Hence the number of accessible states over here will be omega E, over here is omega E prime. So let me call it as omega initial and this as omega final. Okay, so omega E is omega initial, omega prime is omega final. So what's happening? I am processing some system A and after some time this system A arrives at A prime. So for example, suppose I have something like this. I have a chamber in which one section there are some gases and another section is totally empty. And I expanded this particular section so that the gases will expand all over this particular place. So this is my A and this is my A prime, something like this. So the entropy of this initial system will be S initial and the entropy of final system will be S final, right? So what is the relation between this S initial and S final? Kya hota hai? Number of accessible states for a reversible and irreversible system. Reversible, omega initial is equal to omega F, and for irreversible, omega initial is less than omega final. So for any system we have omega initial is always less than or equal to omega final and the entropy is proportional to ln of omega E, correct? Yahan pe dekho. So what does it say about omega initial and omega final? What is the relation with between omega initial and omega final? Will omega initial will be less than or equal to final entropy. Initial entropy will be always less than or equal to final entropy. So this is the second thing that we have discussed. Now what is the zeroth law of thermodynamics? Law kuch is tarah se hai. If I have system A at temperature T, if system A is in equilibrium with system B and system B is in equilibrium with system C, then system A is also in equilibrium with सिस्टम ए. ऐसा कुछ लॉ है, करेक्ट? ओके. इन टर्म्स ऑफ टेम्परेचर दिस लॉ कैन बी स्टेटेड समथिंग लाइक दिस. इफ द टेम्परेचर ऑफ सिस्टम ए इज टी एंड इफ ए इज इन इक्विलिब्रियम विद बी एंड बी इज इन इक्विलिब्रियम विद सी, देन टेम्परेचर ऑफ ए सिस्टम ए इज इक्वल टू टी, देन टेम्परेचर ऑफ सिस्टम सी विल बी इक्वल टू टी. सो इट मीन्स दैट ऑल द सिस्टम्स विल हैव द सेम टेम्परेचर एट इक्विलिब्रियम. That's what this first thing is all about. At equilibrium, the temperature of all the systems is same. So basically, this is your zeroth law of thermodynamics. What is the second law of thermodynamics? Second law of thermodynamics deals with entropy of a system. And you can say that the entropy of a system, irreversible system, always increases. This is the simplest statement of second law of thermodynamics. ये भी तो वही बोल रहा है ना. If I have an irreversible system, then the initial entropy is always less than the final entropy. So the entropy is increasing. So this is the statement of second law of thermodynamics. So as you can see, the statistical mechanics and thermodynamics, they are very closely related together. You cannot have thermodynamics with without statistical mechanics, and you cannot have statistical mechanics without thermodynamics. And the most important play in statistical mechanics is played by which parameter? Can you tell me from this particular discussion? Beta. Beta कैसे define कर रहे हो आप? ln of omega by E, and this is equal to 1 over kT. So temperature is related with what? Omega. Number of accessible state. Entropy किसके लिए कहां पे related है? Omega. Correct? So the most important parameter is your number of accessible state. Omega E is the most important parameter. And that's why we spend so much time on what is accessible state, what is microstate, and how to calculate them, and so on and so forth. So if you know omega E, you can find out anything about statistical mechanics. First, you need to find out what is this omega E. And we have seen how to find that omega E. So that's what we discuss in last few lectures. Then we discuss about this. If I take differentiation of S with respect to E, then that will be ds by dE, which is equal to d by dk of ln of omega plus k dy by ln omega by dy by E. And dk, k is constant, so this will be equal to 0. And ds by dE will be equal to k ln of omega, k ln of, so dy by dy by E of ln of omega. And dy by dy by E of ln of omega will be equal to 1 over kT. So this ds by dE is equal to 1 over T. This is how the temperature is defined. So this gives you the relation between energy and temperature. Then I ask you to solve this particular problem. I have two systems with system A has two particles, system B has three particles, and the total energy is 4E. I ask you to find out what is omega 2E, omega 0 2E, omega prime E prime, 2E. So E prime is equal to 2E. And I also ask you to calculate this omega 0 2E is equal to omega 2E into omega prime E 0 minus E, that would be omega prime 2E. So I guess you might have solved this particular problem. Shall we do that problem? So I have system A having two particles and B three particles. Total energy E0 is 4E. And we need to find out what? Omega 2E, correct? Omega 0 2E. Oh, sorry, this will be 4E, na? Ah, sorry, 2E, sorry. So, ये हमें कैलकुलेट करना है. सो देखो, जब 2E मेरी एनर्जी होंगी फॉर सिस्टम ए, देन उसका रीअरेंजमेंट कैसे होगा? सो दिस इज 0E, 1E एंड 2E. हाउ कैन आई डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द पार्टिकल्स? फर्स्ट इज वन पार्टिकल इन ए, अनदर पार्टिकल इन 0E. दिस इज वन कॉन्फिगरेशन. सेकंड कॉन्फिगरेशन विल बी बोथ पार्टिकल इन 1E. व्हाट इज द नंबर ऑफ एक्सेसिबल स्टेट्स फॉर दिस कॉन्फिगरेशन? That would be 2 factorial divided by 1 factorial into 1 factorial 2. Iski kitne rahenge? 2 factorial divided by 2 factorial, which will equal to 1. So total number of accessible states kitne ho gaye? Right? This is for system A. System B kya thi? 3 particles the mere? 0, E, 2E. Aur energy kitna tha mera? Yahan pe dekho, 2E ke liye find out karna hai. So the first thing is, I can have one particle over here and two particle at energy 0. Second thing is, I can have two particle over here at 1E and one particle at energy 0. Barat? Or kuch configuration hai kya? Possible? Nahi na? So what are the number of accessible states for this? 3 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 1 factorial, that would be equal to 3. And for this, 3 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 1 factorial, that would be equal to 3. So even if you take 3E, it doesn't matter. Na? What I want the energy of a system is 2E. So here is energy, 3E bhi hai, uske 4E hai, 5E hai, it doesn't matter. Kya? Combined system ka configuration kaise likhunga? Combined system is this plus this. Iska configuration kaise likhunga? मगर उसके लिए आपका ए का एनर्जी 2E नहीं रहेगा ना. सो दैट इज आल्सो रेस्ट्रिक्शन की ये यहाँ पे मैं जब लिख रहा हूँ ओमेगा 0 2E, जब मैं लिख रहा हूँ इसका मतलब क्या है कि मेरी टोटल एनर्जी 4E है, राइट? बट ए हैज एनर्जी 2E. दिस इज रिस्ट्रिक्शन द सिचुएशन दैट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इन दैट सिचुएशन ई विल नॉट हैव एनर्जी टू ई सो आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू कंसिडर दैट वो कंसिडर ही नहीं करना है मुझे ऑब्वियसली वो जो आप जो कुछ बातें कर रहे हो ना ये कि यहाँ पे कंबाइन सिस्टम है फॉर एग्जाम्पल यहाँ पे ए बी और यहाँ पे 4E एनर्जी है मेरा 3E 2E 1E एंड 0E सो आई कैन डू समथिंग लाइक दिस कि ए का एनर्जी यहाँ पे लिखूंगा और बाकी दो एक पार्टिकल यहाँ पे रहेगा और बी के सभी पार्टिकल तीनों की तीनों 0 एनर्जी पे रहेंगे सो टोटल एनर्जी मेरा ई 0 कितना हो गया 4E हो गया करेक्ट बराबर है दिस इज काउंटेड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर पैरामीटर टोटल नंबर ऑफ एक्सेसिबल स्टेट्स ऑफ कंबाइंड सिस्टम व्हेन ई जीरो इज इक्वल टू एनर्जी टोटल एनर्जी इज ई जीरो दिस इज काउंटेड ये जो कोई केस है दिस इज काउंटेड इन दिस इसमें आएगा क्या हो नहीं क्योंकि यहाँ पे रिस्ट्रिक्शन क्या है ए हैज एनर्जी टू ई और हमें यहाँ पे क्या कैलकुलेट करने के लिए बोला है मैंने टोटल नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल डिवाइडेड बाय नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल इन ईच सिस्टम टोटल नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स कितने हैं थ्री पार्टिकल 1 2 3 हाँ सो वो हमारा फॉर्मूला ये था n फैक्टोरियल डिवाइडेड बाय n1 फैक्टोरियल इनटू n2 फैक्टोरियल इनटू n3 फैक्टोरियल वेयर कैपिटल n इज द टोटल नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल n1 इज द नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल इन फर्स्ट एनर्जी लेवल n2 इज द नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल इन सेकंड एनर्जी लेवल n3 इज द नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल इन थर्ड एनर्जी लेवल एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ सो यहां पे टोटल नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल 3 है सो 3 फैक्टोरियल डिवाइडेड बाय फर्स्ट एनर्जी में 2 पार्टिकल्स है तो 2 फैक्टोरियल इनटू 0 फैक्टोरियल इनटू 1 फैक्टोरियल सो 0 फैक्टोरियल में कंसीडर नहीं कर रहा हूं बिकॉज़ 0 फैक्टोरियल इज 1 1 So, इसके ओमेगा प्राइम 2e कितना आ गया फिर 3 प्लस 3 6 ओमेगा e इज इक्वल टू 3 ओमेगा प्राइम 2e इज 6 सो व्हाट विल बी ओमेगा 0 2e दैट वुड बी इक्वल टू ओमेगा 2e इनटू ओमेगा प्राइम 2e सो दैट वुड बी 3 × 6 = 18 करेक्ट अभी हमें मैन्युअली वो देखना है कि कैसे होता है सो उसके लिए मैं क्या करूंगा मैं लिखूंगा कि यहाँ पे सिस्टम ए सिस्टम बी और यहाँ पे ई जीरो कितना हो गया सो मेरा फर्स्ट कॉम्बिनेशन क्या हो सकता है कि आई कुड हैव वन पार्टिकल एट 2e अनदर पार्टिकल एट 0 बराबर सो एनर्जी ऑफ फर्स्ट पार्टिकल एनर्जी ऑफ सेकंड पार्टिकल यहाँ पे एनर्जी ऑफ फर्स्ट पार्टिकल सेकंड पार्टिकल एंड थर्ड पार्टिकल और यहाँ पे मुझे टोटल एनर्जी चाहिए 4e तो कैसे अचीव कर सकता हूँ मैं आई कुड हैव 2e 0 0 ये मेरा एक कॉन्फिगरेशन हो गया माइक्रोस्टेट हो गया दूसरा माइक्रोस्टेट मेरा ऐसा आएगा करेक्ट दे विल बी काउंटेड एज सेपरेट ये देखो पहला पार्टिकल 2e में था यहाँ पे भी पहला पार्टिकल 2e में था यहाँ पे पहला पार्टिकल 2e में है यहाँ पे दूसरा पार्टिकल 2e में है यहाँ पे पहला पार्टिकल a का पहला पार्टिकल 2e में है b का तीसरा पार्टिकल 2e में सो दिस एंड दिस आर डिफरेंट दिस एंड दिस इज डिफरेंट सो दिस इज 1 2 एंड 3 अगर आपको सिस्टम के बारे में दिखाना है तो ऐसे दिखा सकता हूँ मैं माई फर्स्ट कॉन्फिगरेशन विल बी a को रेड से दिखाता हूँ यहाँ पे एक ही रहेगा ना ग्रीन इज माय बी सिस्टम बी सो फर्स्ट पार्टिकल ओवर हियर सो दिस इज 1 2 3 दिस इज 1 एंड 2 दिस इज माय फर्स्ट कॉन्फ़िगरेशन सेकंड कॉन्फ़िगरेशन क्या रहेगा माइक्रोस्टेट हाँ थर्ड माइक्रोस्टेट क्या रहेगा मेरा देखो ये जो है वो ये वाला है फर्स्ट सेकंड वाला ये है एंड थर्ड माइक्रोस्टेट ये है बराबर है क्या नेक्स्ट विल बी समथिंग लाइक दिस फोर्थ यहाँ पे 0 रहेगा यहाँ पे 2e रहेगा एंड आई कैन हैव फर्स्ट पार्टिकल इन टू ई जीरो जीरो, पांचवा ऐसा होगा जीरो टू ई जीरो टू ई जीरो, सिक्स नंबर विल बी जीरो टू ई जीरो टू ई सॉरी जीरो जीरो टू ई, सेवेंथ विल बी समथिंग लाइक दिस, फर्स्ट पार्टिकल इन एनर्जी ई सेकंड पार्टिकल इन एनर्जी ई, आई कुड अगेन हैव टू ई जीरो जीरो ई ई जीरो टू ई नाइन्थ ई ई जीरो जीरो टू ई, एज लॉन्ग एज द टोटल एनर्जी इज फोर ई आई डोंट केयर कौन से कैसे कैसे कॉन्फिगुरेशन है। टेंथ अभी क्या रहेगा, अभी आई कैन हैव समथिंग लाइक दिस टू ई जीरो एंड आई कुड हैव ई ई जीरो टू ई जीरो जीरो ई ई टू ई जीरो आई कुड हैव ई जीरो ई, फोर्टीन नंबर विल बी समथिंग लाइक दिस जीरो टू ई जीरो टू ई जीरो टू ई ई ई जीरो ई जीरो ई जीरो ई ई, सिक्सटीन नंबर क्या रहेगा, सिक्सटीन नंबर आई कुड हैव ई ई सेवेंटीन ई ई एटीन ई ई, दिस इज सिक्सटीन ए, और सिस्टम बी में आई कुड हैव ई ई जीरो जीरो ई ई ई जीरो ई, अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस इज देयर एनी अदर कॉन्फिगरेशन पॉसिबल। सो कितने हो गए देखो काउंट करो, वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव सिक्स सेवन एट नाइन टेन इलेवन ट्वेल्व थर्टीन फोर्टीन फिफ्टीन सिक्सटीन सेवनटीन एटीन, so total configuration is omega 0 to e is 18, और यहाँ पे हमने क्या किया था calculation हमारा omega 0 e is 18, कौन सा easy लगा आपको ये इतना सारा करते बैठना या ये first वाला, ये कर क्यों रहे हम by the way, Why we want this number of accessible states? वही मैंने यहाँ पे बताया है। Because this is very important, most important parameter, omega e. Number of accessible states से you can find anything in statistical mechanics. वही सबसे ज़्यादा important है। So you should know how to find these accessible states. Can you do the second problem? Okay. So try to solve this second problem. जो आप दिया हुआ था ठीक है, सो सी यू इन 45 मिनट्स, ओके थैंक यू फॉर योर टाइम।